by recognizing the brother and sister members of our Labor Management Committee. Each has contributed greatly to the success of the committee, and each is worthy of your recognition. They have distinguished themselves with their efforts on behalf of the membership, their locals, and or states. They should both be very proud of their efforts. As I introduce each, would they please stand and be recognized by the body. The committee members are Alex Alleman, President, San Antonio, Alamo City, Local, Texas. Bruce Amy, MVS Director, Atlanta, Georgia, Local. Dina Briscoe, President, Nation's Capital, Southern Maryland Area, Local. John Marcotte, President, Gaylord, Michigan, Local, and the Michigan Postal Workers Union. Cindy Martinez, President, Texas Postal Workers Union, and member of the McAllen, Texas Local. Anna Smith, President, Oregon Postal Workers Union, and member of the Portland, Oregon Area Local. And we have an honorary member of our committee who was not able to serve due to injury but is sorely missed, Joe McGugan, Vice President, Philadelphia BMC Local, Philadelphia, PA. And as Chairman of the Labor Management Committee, I am Mike Dennehy, President of Bridgeport, Connecticut Area Local. The committee wishes to expressly thank Director of Industrial Relations, Greg Bell, Technical Advisor, Phil DeVita, and our EPW Secretary, Janice McGalvin, for all their help, assistance, and patience. The members of the Labor Management have deliberated over each of the resolutions submitted to our committee. We thank the membership for taking the time to submit these resolutions for your consideration as together we try to overcome some of management's more insidious practices. Our determinations were made based on the following principles. We've made our recommendations based on the resolutions as they were submitted to us. We have not amended any resolution, although in some cases minor amendments alone would have made a non-concurred resolution otherwise acceptable. Any such amendment or substitution would have to come from the floor. In those cases where resolutions were adequately addressed by previous conventions, we have noted the resolutions as previously adopted, thereby requiring no further action by this assembly. And if it works right, those will be displayed on the screens for your viewing. In those cases where multiple resolutions have identical or nearly identical resolves, we have referred each to the strongest resolution presented for action by the body. We referred one resolution to Motor Vehicle Services Committee and three to the Clerk Craft Committee because we felt those resolutions were specific to those crafts only and were best reported on by the crafts involved. Those resolutions that we have recommended concurrence, they speak for themselves, and we support as presented. Finally, for those resolutions that we have recommended non-concurrence, we have stated the basis for our objections. And again, we remind the body that in some of those instances, minor alterations alone would have made the overall resolution acceptable. Resolution 1, Article 1, supervisors doing craft work required to clock to craft function.